I made this picture frame stock with just two router bits and a table saw, and I thought I'd show you how. This is not an overly ornate frame, which is the way I like it. I think the artwork should be the focus and the frame should just sort of support it, so I like a fairly subtle look. This is a roundover bit, it'll cut the outside curve, and this is a cove bit, this will cut the inside curve. If you have a router table with a starter set of bits, you probably already have these, they're very common. So we'll start with some rough stock. I'm using cherry for this project. I'll cut it to rough length and then I'll take it to the joiner. I'll joint one face, joint the adjoining edge, and then I'll take it over to the thickness planer where we'll bring it down to finish thickness. Now all the dimension in this project are really up to you. I'm going with something about 2 inches wide by about an inch or 3/4 of an inch thick. It really, you know, whatever your artwork suits. I've done stuff that's like an inch, 1 1/4 thick. I've done stuff 3 inches wide. I've done stuff, you know, 2 inches wide. You know, it all suits what you're doing. This video is really more about the technique than the dimensions. With the stock prepared, the first thing I'm gonna do is take the splitter off of my table saw, because I want to run a sort of dado on this, which isn't really a dado, because what we're going to do is we're going to set the blade height to maybe 1/16 of an inch, and then we're going to run 2 grooves down the stock. For the first cut, I set the table saw at about 1/2 inch. For the second cut, I moved it over about 3/16 and then took another cut. Again, none of these dimensions are critical. It's up to you. What this does is it just gives a little bit of a shadow line on the picture, adds a little bit of visual interest. If you were doing a wider picture, you might do it 3 times. If you were doing a wider picture frame, you might cut it 3 times. The next 2 operations are on the router table. Pull out my portable router table and get it set up. So I'm first going to cut the cove and then I'm going to cut the round over. These are both fairly aggressive cutting operations, and so usually with the router table I would recommend doing 2 passes. You first do a shallow cut and then a second larger cut, and in fact I'll probably do 3 passes where I'll do the 2 major cuts and then you just tap the fence like, you know, 1/2 millimeter or something for just a nice cleanup finishing cut to hopefully take out most of the burning, because I use cheap router bits, so I usually get some burning. So I got the cove cut first, and now I've got the roundover bit in, and I'm gonna finish this off with the roundover. So here's a close-up of what we've just done. We've used a roundover bit to curve the outside of this stock. We use the saw blade to cut these 2 grooves, and then the cove bit, we cut the inside, and that gives us this picture frame stock. And so that's my technique for making what I think are some simple and elegant picture frames with just a couple of basic router bits and a table saw. Now when it comes to actually mounting the frames around a piece of artwork, you may want to cut a rabbet along the inside. You could do that on the router table or on the table saw. I'll leave that as an exercise for the viewer, as they say. Well, that's about it for this one. As always, I'd like to thank you for stopping by and spending some time in my shop. I hope you found something interesting and enjoyable. If you feel I've earned it, please hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.